We primarily rely on two tools. We primarily rely on the professional codes of ethics and case studies. We do talk about ethical theory, and we do use some heuristic models for dealing with ethical dilemmas. We introduce the students to ethical dilemmas or like design problems model because they're all very familiar with the design process. But we really rely on the professional codes of ethics as kind of the setting of standards and expectations, even though there are some contradictions in pretty much all the professional codes of ethics. They wouldn't really stand up to philosophical muster, but they provide a lot of guidance and insight. And then we use the case studies to make the things real, and I guess in my mind to give them some impact. One of the things that's important to me is that the students develop a little better sense of working probability. A lot of these accidents that have occurred in engineering systems are because people didn't really grasp that because something is unlikely doesn't mean it won't happen. And so many of the mistakes and errors that have led to disasters have been easily preventable if people had been more careful or more thoughtful. And the case studies get the students interested. I mean, they like the case studies, and they can relate them back to some of the technical issues. So we really focus on those two, but we go pretty far and wide in the case studies. We cover sometimes dozens, depending on the class and the student interest.